division bar. And we are dividing by 5. So 5 is our divisor. It goes on the end. Whenever you see decimals within a division problem, you need to ask yourself a question. And it's at the top of your head. If so, if your divisor is whole, you can bring your decimal straight up. That's where it's going to go. By 5 straight up. So 48. Once you do that, you just go through the division steps.
So we can put a 0 divided by 5.
Multiply. Subtract. Bring down. And repeat.
So we can start
out
with
4 divided by
9
of 5. Pull any whole groups of 5 out of 4. So we need to jump over.
Subtract,
eight.
We can do.
Subtract, we get 3. Whole groups of 5 out of 35.
Zeros
well,
at
7.
The end of a decimal does not change. Bring down.
So happy you could die. I told myself that you were right for me.
Welcome to Math with Mr. J. So I'm going to cover how to divide a whole number by a decimal. So let's jump into our two examples here. And for number tenths, so let's set this up. Welcome to Math with Mr. J. By 5. And the first thing we need to do is set this goes underneath the division bar. And we are dividing.
We're asked to compute 3,060 to figure out how many times is 36 and go.
Welcome to Math with Mr. J. In this video, I'm going to be covering how to divide a decimal by a whole number. So we have two examples here that we're going to go through together in order to get this down. So let's jump into number one, where we have 4 and 85 hundredths divided by 5. And the first thing we need to do is set this problem up. So 4 and 85 hundredths here, this is our dividend. It's the number that's being divided or split up.